Hi, happy Monday. So I'm here shooting today as a model for Narelle, a jewelry brand. I have all of the jewelry on here. I've got bracelets everywhere and I'm standing in the good light. We have nice shadow style theme for the shoot. I have like a Zara outfit on that's green, which I love. And it's going well. We have the rest of the team here. Everyone say hi. Hello. Yeah, I'm sure I will show you guys the photos soon when they're out. How long will the photos be?
Just next week.
Next week? Yeah? Lovely. Talk soon. Hi, so I've just finished off at my client's place at Repulse Bay. That's my last one before I leave. I did a lash lift and brow lamination and she's like my favorite long-term client. I love her dearly. But the photo shoot earlier this morning went really well. I didn't have much turnaround between ending that and coming out here. I just went home to I should have got that cup. I need to get a cup. I just went home to have some food and then came out here. And now I'm going to get a cab home for more packing. Yeah. But no, the photo shoot went really well. I was really happy with how the photos were looking on the back of the camera. They were, yeah, great. And I'm excited for that to come out. I liked the wardrobe, I liked the lighting, everything. So that was really good. Really, really good. Okay, now I'm really gonna get the next cab that drives past.
TG, first thing you should put in your mouth is the egg.
Hello, say hi, good morning.
I think I've got a bad hair day.
Having an early breakfast and then Shane's helping us move a few things at our favourite coffee shop, Fine Print.
Oh.
And that's it, last full day in Hong Kong.
This is your farewell breakfast.
It is, it is. Hi boys, hello.
Hi.
There they are. Shane's taking our weights. And the boys are carrying the weights for me. Off to Shane's home. Oh my god, so funny. We're just in Sheung Wan, quickly grabbing some euro before we leave. Sheung Wan is just a place that is full of exchange shops for money. So we're just looking around for the best price. My hair is still drying from Shane washing it quickly this morning. So it's quite fluffy at the moment, but yeah, it is. My brain is so scattered and manic right now and we're just looking for a good price to get some euro before we go. We have to check into the hotel soon, so we're staying at a hotel tonight so that we can just like get everything out of the apartment and have it really like empty before tomorrow where we do the handover. Getting ran over. Okay, so we've got the cash at the bank. We actually ended up going to the bank anyway. But I'm just walking past this building and there is, oh my gosh, a lot of memories in this building. I used to live in this building every time I would come back to Hong Kong in my like nomadic travels and rent a really little tiny hole in the wall service apartment here for years. And this is Wing Luk Street and it has like all the Shark Fin District. They have like all these like local stores that sell all the like seafood things for soup, everything's for soup. And yeah, that's the building. 115 Wingworth Street. For years and years and years. And they're now not service apartments anymore. I just thought I'd show you.
Hi guys, so we just checked into the hotel that is basically across the road. Edwin booked the hotel for the night just so things are a little bit more easier back at the apartment. We've moved everything that we're taking to Paris with us into the hotel, and then everything left in the apartment, it goes in the bin, is being picked up, and then we can clean it all. So one night here before we fly off tomorrow. And I want to give you a room tour. It's really sweet. It's actually like a very big room.
You can see Peel Street.
And we can see our balcony from the room, so it's really sweet. So I'll flip you around and show you. So here you come in. And by the way, this is the Madeira Hotel. Okay, so this is where you come in. We have some shelves. Opens up onto the living room. TV, lounge with Edwin, hello, hi. Then you have a full kitchen. I've just dumped all my things there. And they say that the mini bar is, well, this is the same one I have. Where's the mini bar? Not too much. Then I'll show you. We come into here, into the bedroom. So nice. Look at that. It's actually really big.
It's a nice place to stay there.
And from this window, you can see our apartment and our terrace. You can see it down there. Down there was our terrace, that whole bit there. Our plants have gone now, a lot of them. But that was our terrace. Because, yeah, looking on the terrace at night, you can look up back up at this hotel. That was the building there that we lived in. I've got views of Hong Kong. We have views of Peel Street on this side. Let me show you. There and the rest of mid-levels. Oh, and let me show you the bathroom. The bathroom is actually really amazing. There I am again. Look at this. It's so big. Wow. This is quite nice. Table. Nice marble. I mean, I'm not a fan of the color scheme at all. Like the blue and yellow is a little bit too stark for me, but that's fine. It's lovely. So yeah, don't get to really enjoy it all that much. I have many things to do. I need to go to get a new phone glass cover on my phone. Just a few things like that, just because, I mean, I don't know where to do that in Paris. Get a phone cover. It'll just be easier if I can just go get one done here before I leave. And then I have people picking up the beds at about half an hour. Picking up the bed, picking up the umbrella. So I'm gonna go run and do the phone case first. And my day is so manic. I've moved to the strap phone thing, so I can run around and have my phone with me still. But yeah, hopefully by tonight, later tonight, we will be able to chill in here.
Okay.
Staying in this hotel tonight. I'm now carrying a mattress down a hill. The person that picking up the bed didn't want to take the mattress. So that's it. Oh my god, hang on. Here's the mattress. Hey, so I've just gotten back to the hotel room. which is such a treat. I'm so glad that we booked this. Thank you, darling. And I just had dinner with Shane at the vegan buffet restaurant, which is like, it's so good. I'm like, I should have went there more. But yeah, just really just got here and just replying to so many messages about picking up last things that I'm selling, and yeah, just going to spend the rest of the night here relaxing,
trying to
sorting out the my suitcases, do a face mask, still message people, but yeah, and then hopefully can get into like the mindset of being excited that I'm going to be in Paris in like a day or two. Wow. I hope everything goes smoothly. Okay, I'm going to sign off tonight. Good night. Good morning. It is like 7:30 in the morning. And it's nice to wake up in the hotel, but I have to go back across the road and finish off taking loads of rubbish out of the apartment. Go to the post office, mail a box back home to Australia. Just extra things that won't fit in my suitcase and just like memorabilia stuff. And hopefully someone will pick up the wooden table. I woke up to so many messages about that. And yeah, then we hand over the keys or whatnot at like midday. Before that, I'll come back here and like have a shower and get ready. And then we hand over the keys. But there's no keys to hand over, it's a password door, so yeah, but I better get up and on. Another big day, flying day. We're taking this stuff to the dump and it just fell apart on the road. Oh my gosh. Yeah, I put this together. Amazing thing is this Gage Street refuse collection point is available for us just around the corner. Like, it's still a bit of a walk when you have heavy things. It's open 24 hours. They keep this door open here and you can just leave your rubbish here, which is really, really handy right here at the markets. So if anyone needs to know, 24 hours. Look at this, we're at the airport and the stores are empty. That is so sad. Gucci. Empty. Inside, no stock. There's a couple little bits there. Everything else is closed. This is the flight board, as you guys know, normally full of flights. That's the flights for today. That's it. This is Hong Kong still. Still living. Hello, so we have made it. We are stationed at our gate. Just excuse how I look. I have no idea how I look. I have no makeup on today. It was actually quite fast to come in, but not smooth. We had to sit on the floor at the gate, check in and book a ticket out of France, because the lady was like, I need to see your exiting ticket out of France. And we're like, well, we don't have one. We don't know when we're leaving. Like, well, we know like we're gonna be there for a month, but we haven't decided where we're going yet. So we both had to just kind of look at each other and work out what we were going to do. And so we're like, okay, let's just book a cheap bus ticket or train ticket out of France. And like, if it's refundable, we'll just refund it, right? And we just show her that we've bought this ticket. So I sat down and we looked at Google Maps and I typed in Paris and I looked at the closest city outside of Paris or outside of France, and that was Brussels. So, I mean, we knew that, but we're just double checking. Amsterdam is further than Brussels. So Brussels, and then I looked at like the time to get to Brussels, like potentially if we're gonna actually take this trip. It's quicker by train than by bus. It's like an hour and 20 minute journey. So we booked it. A one-way train ticket from Paris to Brussels. Maybe I know that person, I'm not sure. And then, yeah, then we showed it to her. So I'm potentially going for a day trip to Brussels while I'm in Paris. Or we'll refund it, I'm not really sure yet. But we can work that out in like a week. And I'm now just going for a walk in the airport. And I'm really thirsty and I just want to buy something to drink. Anything, literally anything. But a lot of things are closed, and we walked past one area that said you cannot go back if you go past this area. And yeah, there's a few staff here, so I'm gonna ask some people if there's a vending machine or anything, because everything is just closed. I just showed you, even the Gucci and Saint Laurent stores are like empty, no stock. It's just wild. But anyway, that's my little journey. Everything else is fine coming in. Okay, I'm gonna ask this person. Okay, I found a bottle of Fiji water. 20 Hong Kong dollars. But that's life, that was the only water. On our stopover at Doha Airport, and everything is back to normal. It's like entering the world again. It's really weird. So there's people from all around the world. It's been like over 2 years since I've seen that. Yeah, people are everywhere. Lots of people without masks. Busy. It's around like 12 at night here. No, 11. And then we're just waiting for the information for our gate to come up. So have a look around first. Hi, so we're now in our apartment that we're staying at for the next month in Paris. I've had a shower, freshened up, and we've just kind of packed all of our things away in the drawers and things. And I will show you the view and stuff later, but I'm just gonna go get like a phone card and bottles of water and stuff and a few necessities.
Bye.
Good morning. This is our local park. It's absolutely stunning. So beautiful. This is Place de Fossage. Here I am looking like a gnome. But it was good to sleep last night. But yeah, just woken up. It is so peaceful and quiet here. Just walking around. We're gonna then walk towards Bastille and get some breakfast, croissants and coffee. And yeah, we're just checking in the neighborhood, wandering around the sites. It's quite cool. But it still feels really weird to not have a mask on. I don't know how long that's gonna take to get over that feeling. I mean, 2.5 years of wearing a mask every day is a long time. So yeah, leaving the apartment, I just feel like I'm missing something, and yeah, but it's okay. And also, like, when Edwin takes photos of me, it's like I don't have to be like, oh wait, let me try to take my mask off for a second. My mask is already gone. It's amazing. Hello, so it's our second full day here in Paris, and I just want to come and have a little chat and tell you how it's going, because it's been, you know, we've done a lot, but we've also been very tired. It's like 3 o'clock in the afternoon now, and I haven't done all that much today because we did just have like a nap, because we're just, you know, still getting used to the time difference and things like that. But I did like go for a walk this morning, and we had breakfast at a cafe, and then I posted a video and did some work and things.
But yeah, we're gonna go out really soon. I just did my makeup, put my lipstick on. I have a bright summery orangey red color from Tom Ford. I think I'm going to be wearing like lipstick every single day, because that's one of the things I want to say, is that it still, even though it's like day two or three, feels so strange leaving the apartment without a mask or like putting one on. I still always have one in my bag, just because, you know, 2.5 years of wearing a mask every day, it just becomes a part of you, right? And now no one wears a mask. Very few people, like, you notice when someone wears a mask. That's how often people don't wear masks. And it's fantastic. At one point yesterday when we were in a quite narrow street and it was very busy, I did get a little bit panicky and felt like I wanted to put one on, or I would have just been more calm if I just put one on. But it's okay. I'm sure those feelings will get less and less. Yeah, our apartment is going to work out fine. It's working well and we have a beautiful view. It's so beautiful. The sun is like just shining and beaming, so I need to find a hat solution, some sun protection. And yeah, today we're gonna go walk to, I think it's called Galeries Lafayette. It's a big department store, but it takes like 40 minutes to walk there. So I think obviously we'll be stopping off and getting distracted along the way. I want to have a look at some handbags and things. So yeah, and then we'll get dinner somewhere. We've already had dinner at lovely places. Yesterday we went to Café de Flore. How do you say the cafe? Café de Flore, which is a very famous cafe. And it was very busy as well, but we got a seat and it was fine. I had a dark hot chocolate and then we shared like a cheese platter, which was really large and very rich and intense cheeses. A little bit much for some of the cheeses were a little bit too much for us, but we finished it and it was nice. But yeah, that's just the Paris life, is just hanging out at cafes, eating it slowly, watching people, and it's really nice to do that. Edwin knows Paris quite well. He's come here many, many times, so, and spent a lot of time here, so it's helpful. He kind of shows me around places, but I always have my Google Maps. I like to see where I am on a map, and like that way I can like feel like I understand the city a little bit more and get to know it. Yeah, but we'll go for a walk. There's a really cute dog. Often the dogs here that I see, they do look like they always need a wash. I don't know why. Is that a French thing? They don't wash and groom the dogs that often, but they always look very dusty, if that makes sense. They look kind of dusty. But yeah, it's great. We're on like the second floor, so we can like watch people and stuff. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Okay, I've been talking for 5 minutes. Bye. Thank you. for dinner we have falafel, which is a savior always in Europe for me as a vegetarian. And we'll just find somewhere to sit and eat it. But we've done lots and lots of walking. We went to that big mall that I showed you. It was just really too busy. I didn't really enjoy it that much. So we're just gonna work out at the bars here, do some stretches and some exercises before we could eat more pastries. Oh, and we're gonna go to a market, a local weekend like market with food and things, like a fruit market. See ya. To buy this little pot of lavender for our apartment. Bonjour. Thank you. Hello, just discovered this little park, didn't look like much, but then there are these beautiful gardens. Let me spin around the camera and show you. Look at this, it's so groomed and manicured and so pretty. How beautiful. Look at these wild looking flowers. Oh, I love this one. Oh, doing another one. You can keep telling me about the lovely vegan places.
Okay, we have the Barioli du Maud, which is